Hello everyone, this video is dedicated to Emily and Michelle. I don't dedicate videos that often, but this is kind of a one-time thing. This video is going to be a review of Transformers 2, Michael Jackson, and Billy Mays. Okay, let's get to the Michael Jackson first. Michael Jackson died at 50 years of age, June 25th, 2009. He almost was 51, and everybody is just, he was the king of pop. Lots of album selling, number one selling album ever. This guy was a superstar. When he died, the searches on his name on Google crippled the internet. Seriously. I was trying to go on YouTube and Facebook and stuff, and that shit was slow. Seriously. But anyway, Michael Jackson was definitely the king of pop. A lot of people are looking past the supposed, you know, molestation thing that he might have done. A lot of people don't believe he did it and that they were just suing him for money, but he had very loyal fans. I first heard that he died, before he actually died. I turned on CNN, and they were just saying he'd gone into cardiac arrest. They were still talking about it, and then about an hour, I don't know, a bit later, I turned on CNN again, and it turns out he finally died. Then everybody was in mourning this past couple days. He's been in the headlines on every major news station, playing the Thriller video, talking about all his impact on the world, and blah blah blah. But I have to say, the guy did have some great songs. He could dance a hell of a lot better than a lot of people, but apparently a Doc Demerol, an overdose of Demerol, caused his death. The side effect of it is cardiac arrest, so that's what killed him. But anyway, rest in peace, Michael Jackson, even though you might have molested a few kids. 1958 to 2009. Okay, this other guy, I had a bit of respect for Michael Jackson as a performer, but this guy I have zero respect. I'm kind of glad he's dead. I know that's, you know, a bad thing to say, but who gives a shit? Okay, Billy Mays is the biggest bullshitter in the world. He's constantly bullshitting about OxyClean and other shit that supposedly is immaculate and just fixes every problem you have. This guy is a huge sellout, and I'm kind of glad he's dead. He's basically a bullshitter, and I'm not going to be surprised if they rented out some advertisement space on his gravestone. But anyway, here's my Transformers 2 review. The movie was packed. Everybody's going to see it. It's going to be another summer blockbuster. It's going to be a smash. It's going to make, I think, at least $100 million. It's been packed. It came out Wednesday, and it was like, this was the opening day. It's just amazing. I just can't wait to hear the numbers for the box office and everything. A lot of reviewers bitch about how noisy it is, and just, the action isn't as good. The action is way better this time around. You can actually tell more what's going on. It's not just, you know, big machines rolling around. You can tell what's going on. The acting sound, characters are likable, except one guy. I'm not going to spoil anything, but this movie is better than the original. It gets a 4.5. A 4.5. It's really good. The other one was about a 4 to a 3.5. It was good. Some people can watch it over and over. I thought it was great the first time, but the second time, you know, it kind of lost a bit of its, I don't know, just interest. I lost a bit of interest in it the second time. But anyway, the movie is good. Definitely watch it. Maybe try to watch it later this week. If you don't like crowds, definitely don't go tomorrow, because there still might be quite a few crowds. I don't know. I don't predict how many people will go to see that movie, but it's going to do really well. That's really all I have to say. Rest in peace, Michael Jackson, go see Transformers 2, and screw you, Billy Mays. I hate your advertisements. Okay, goodbye, YouTube. See you next week some other time.